Now we'll study in detail about a scalar product of two vectors. As we have already studied that when we talk about a scalar product here, the result is a scalar, which do not have any direction. Now when we talk about a scalar product, there are several ways by which we can calculate the scalar product. We'll first discuss if we find scalar product of two vectors, A vector and B vector. And it is written as C is equals to A vector dot B vector. And this is the way how we represent the scalar product, and C is the result of the product of A and B vector, and the scalar product, which is also written as dot product, this is represented by placing a dot between the symbol of the two vectors. Here, the C is just having a magnitude, it is not having any direction. The magnitude of C is given as AB cos theta, where A and B are the magnitudes of the vectors A and vector B, and here theta is the angle between A vector and B vector. So, as the C is AB cos theta, we can simply state if there are two perpendicular vectors. Perpendicular vector means if the angle between them is 90 degree, then their scalar product or dot product is always 0. You can also write down a note. This is, itself is a very important property which is used several times in physics, that is scalar product of two perpendicular vectors is always 0. And we can simply state if there are two identical vectors, say A vector and A vector, we take the dot product, it will be A into cos 0, this becomes A square. So you can also write the scalar product of two identical vectors is equal to square of the magnitude. Like if we take up A vector dot A vector, this will directly give us A square into cos 0. So it is just A square. So always keep both of these things in mind, that scalar product or dot product of two perpendicular vectors is always 0, and that of two identical vectors is always equal to the square of the magnitude. Similarly, if there are two parallel vectors, then the scalar product can be written as A into B into cos 0, this is just AB. For parallel vectors, the scalar product is the product of the magnitude. That also you can keep in mind. If we find out the scalar product of unit vectors, we can simply state for two identical unit vectors, say A cap and A cap. If we take the dot product of two identical vectors, we have studied that it is equal to the square of the magnitude, and as the magnitude of a unit vector is 1, so product of two identical unit vectors is always 1. And the same is valid for standard vectors also. So if we talk about for a standard unit vectors, we can simply write I cap dot I cap or J cap dot J cap or k cap dot k cap, this must be equals to 1. Similarly, for the perpendicular vectors, if we write I cap dot j cap or j cap dot k cap or k cap dot I cap, all these are equal to 0 as these are perpendicular vectors. And using this concept very easily, we can multiply two vectors which are given or which are represented in form of unit vectors. Like if we take up an example, if say we are given with A vector as 2i cap plus 4j cap minus 3k cap, and another vector B vector is defined as I cap minus 3j cap plus 7k cap, and we are required to find A vector dot B vector. This result we are required to find. We can simply say, as we are finding the dot product or scalar product, the result will just be a numerical value or a magnitude. So here we can say, if we find out the result C, which is equals to A dot B, and we put the values of A vector and B vector in terms of unit vector, it is 2i cap plus 4j cap minus 3k cap dot product with the I cap minus 3j cap plus 7k cap. So in this situation, if we multiply the two, we can simply see 2i cap dot I cap will become 2, because I cap dot I cap becomes 1. Now 2i cap dot minus 3j cap will be 0 because I and j are perpendicular. Similarly, I and k will also be 0 because they are also perpendicular. If we come to the second term, it is 4j cap. When we take the dot product with I cap, it is 0. When we take the dot product with minus 3j cap, it will be 4 into minus 3, it will be minus 12. As j dot j becomes 1, as we already studied. Similarly, and the dot product of j cap dot k cap will be 0 as they are perpendicular. And for the third term, again we need to multiply it only with the last term, because first two terms the product is going to be 0. So it will be minus 21. So here we can see the result, that will be minus 31. That is our answer. So this minus 31 is the dot product of this A vector and B vector. So for any case, whenever we are given with the vectors in terms of unit vectors, in case of dot product or calculation of dot product, you can multiply the coefficients of corresponding unit vectors, like I cap dot I cap, this will be 2, J and J, it will be minus 12, K and K, it will be minus 21, directly take up the summation of that. This will give you the result of dot product of two vectors given in unit vector form. Now we'll study how to find out the angle between two vectors. Say we are having two vectors, A vector and B vector. And we know if we take the scalar product of the two vectors, the scalar product can be written as, say, the result is A dot B. Its result will be A B cos theta, where A and B are the magnitudes of A vector and B vector, and theta is the angle between the two. So from here we can write cos theta is equals to A vector dot B vector upon AB. Here we all know that a vector divided by its magnitude gives us a unit vector. So here A vector dot A becomes A cap, that is unit vector in the direction of A vector, and B vector divided by B will be B cap. So it can be written as A cap dot B cap. So here the value of angle between the two vectors can be written as cos inverse of A cap dot B cap. This itself is a very useful term. If you know the concept of a scalar product or dot product, using the scalar product concept, you can directly find out the angle between the two given vectors. It is equals to cos inverse of the dot product of the unit vectors in their direction. Let's see an example in the same concept. Say we are required to find the angle between P vector, that is given as 3i cap plus 2j cap plus k cap, and another Q vector, which is I cap plus j cap plus k cap. We are required to find the angle between these vectors. So we first find out the unit vectors along P vector and Q vector. In this situation, we can state unit vectors in the direction of P vector and Q vector R. Here you can see P cap will be equals to P vector by its magnitude. So it is 3i cap plus 2j cap plus k cap divided by, the magnitude will be 3 square plus 2 square plus 1. This is 9 plus 4, 13. This is plus 1, that is root 14. Similarly, we find out Q cap, it is I cap plus J cap plus K cap divided by its magnitude, that is root 3. Now, if theta is angle between P vector and Q vector, this implies we can write theta is equals to cos inverse of P cap dot Q cap. So here it gives us cos inverse of P P and Q, when we take up the dot product, you can see it is 3 into 1, 3 plus 2 into 1 plus 1 into 1. This will become 3 plus 2 plus 1 upon this root of 14 into 3, that will be 42. So, this becomes cos inverse of root 6 by 7. This is the answer to our question, that is the angle between the given P vector and Q vector. Now we'll study a concept of physics, that is calculation of work done by a force using dot product. I think you all have studied in previous classes that work can be given as force applied multiplied by the displacement in the direction of force. This is the way how we calculate the work done by a force. Say, for a simple example, we consider a smooth ground and on ground we place an object and we apply a force F onto it in a direction theta above the horizontal. Now, if we apply a force F at an angle theta, we can see that there are two components of this force which are acting on the body, or say the block A. One will be F cos theta along the horizontal direction, other will be F sin theta, which is in the direction perpendicular to horizontal, that is vertical direction. Now, we know well that if F sin theta is less than the weight, it is not going to be displaced in vertical direction. But F cos theta is going to pull the block in horizontal direction. And let us assume the block is displaced in horizontal direction by a distance S. So, here S will be the displacement of this block along the direction of force F cos theta, and here along the direction of the force component F sin theta, there is no displacement. So, here we can say no work is done by the vertical component of the force, and here for displacement only the horizontal component or X component or this F cos theta is responsible. So, here if we calculate the work done by force, this work can be written as F cos theta into the displacement S. It can be written as Fs cos theta. Here you can carefully see that the theta is the angle between the force vector and the displacement vector. So, we can write this work in terms of dot product of the two, that is F dot S. So, you are given with the force vector and displacement vector directly by taking the dot product, we can find out the work done by the force. As you know, the units of work we consider in joule, if force is in Newton and displacement is in meters. Let's have a look on this example. It says a body is placed at 4, 3, 1 is displaced to another point which is 5, 2, 4 by applying a force, that is I cap minus J cap plus 4 K cap. We are required to find the work done by the force. Now, in this situation, we all know very well that the work done by the force can be calculated by the dot product of force multiplied by the displacement, or the dot product of force vector and displacement vector. In this situation, we are already having force vector as I cap minus J cap plus 4 K cap. If we find out displacement vector, we know well that displacement vector can be given as position vector of final point minus position vector of initial point. We just find out the position vectors, these can be directly given by the coordinates. Like for the final position, the position vector is 5 I cap plus 2 J cap plus 4 K cap minus the position vector of initial point is 4 I cap plus 3 J cap plus K cap. If we find out the displacement vector, the value of displacement vector is I cap minus J cap plus 3 K cap. This is the displacement vector. So, here work done can be directly calculated as F dot delta S, and its value will be I cap minus J cap plus 4 K cap dot product with I cap minus J cap plus 3 K cap. So, you can see what result will be getting. I dot I, it will be 1. minus j dot minus j will be plus 1 plus 4 into 3 is 12. This will be 14. This will be 14 units of work which is done. We can also state that if force is measured in Newton and displacement is measured in meters, then this unit will be joules. This will be the answer to our question.